This is my stew. Hello, everybody. Hello, everybody. This is your girl, Tina. Tina Modi NS. This is my stew. If it's your first time on my channel, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and like the screen for me. If you want to know how I prepare this stew, please watch this video to the end. You will see the ingredients and everything that I use. Watch this video to the end. This is the stew. Subscribe and like my screen for me. Hello, my people. I'm here again. It's your girl, Tina Ernest. Tina Mode Ernest. I want to make Nigeria stew. So I have my goat meat here, my cow meat, and my cow leg. It's here. And I have my dry chicken. Can see my dry chicken is here, and I have my onions, my fresh fish, and the tomatoes. I blend the fresh pepper and the fresh pepper and the onions together. So I want to parboil the tomatoes. I have my maggi here. This is my salt, because I love to boil my tomatoes before I can fry it. This is the meat, my dry onions, my fresh onions. I have to add my curry panda inside. Curry panda inside the meat. As I said before, I will not add water because I like my meat to boil like 5 minutes before adding water inside the meat. So for the meat set is okay now. I already on the gas. 5 minutes I'll come and add water inside, then I will turn it together before adding my water. So this is the meat. So I want to turn it together now. Later I will not add my water inside. So yes, this is the meat. It's time to add water. So this is my water. Okay. So I'm gonna leave the meat to done. Thank you all for watching. Please stay with me. Watch this video to the end. God bless you. Hello, my people. The meat. Done, the meat is okay like this. So I'm going to the set of fry the meat now. This is the fish. I will have a little salt inside the fish. This is the meat. I'm going to the set of fry the meat and the fish now. The pot is on the fire. So let it dry. I will now add my oil inside. Okay, let's put our oil. Okay, my people, the oil is hot now. Let's put a little salt. Then our fish. Okay, our fish is here now. Then later we'll now fry our meat. Okay, my people, let's pack our fish. You can see the fish is dry. I'm going to pack it now. I'm going to pack the fish. I'm packing the fish. Then I'll now come and fry my meat. I'm going to fry both the cow leg, everything. Yes. Sometimes I fry my pomo and meat. You see the color of the cow leg this side? This is how the cow leg look when you fry it. You see it? This is how it look when you are frying the cow leg. Sometimes you can also fry your pomo if you want. Because I normally fry my meat if I make it stew. But if I make it soup, I'm packing my meat. So the next set now for the stew. Okay, my people, we are the set of frying the stew. I'm adding my groundnut oil inside the pot now. Okay, the oil is hot. Now I'll put my onions inside. You leave the onions to done at least 2 minutes before putting your thing to mash together. So you see the color, very red. That's why I like that tea tomatoes to use. So this is it. So this is the stew. So what next? I'm going to put my meat. Because the tomatoes, I boiled it before, and the tea tomatoes is already done. So now I'm going to put my meat for everything to mix together. So that is it. So my meat is coming inside now. Okay. Turn together. So that is it. The meat is coming inside. See. So what next? I'll put my fish. Before putting my fish inside, I'll put my dry chicken. I wash it before. I'll put my dry chicken inside. So my fish is coming inside now. I'm going to put my fish inside. This is the fish. So what next? I will have my ingredients inside, my curry, my salt, my maggi. So this is my curry powder. I will add a little bit inside. You see the color? I love my gas. As I said before, you can use this one to cook any food of your choice. Stew, soup, spinach, any food at all, you can use it to cook it. So I'm going to pour it inside as well. I'm going to pour this one inside. This one is just for the color, just to give the stew color. There's nothing more. I'm going to pour it inside. You can see the color is red. It's turning together. Then what next is my meat water. My meat water. Then I will now test it. Then before I did the salt, before putting my mangi. So that is it. So I'm turning my meat water inside now. Turn it together. At least I will leave it for 5 minutes. Then I will now come back and test. Before I now add salt and mangi. This is it. Let us check our stew. Wow. This is the stew. This is the stew. So this time now, I'm going to test the stew and see if it needs salt and mangi so that I will know. I have tested the stew. It needs a little bit salt, and maybe one mangi or two mangi. This is the mangi I like use preparing my stew. You can see. This is it. You can use it to prepare any type of your food of your choice, but I like it on my stew. I'm going to add two pieces of this mangi. You can see it's two. Put it inside. Turn it together. And see, wow. My stew is beautiful. So what next now? I will now add my ebewaye inside. Ebewaye inside. Okay, my people. So this is the fish. Ebewaye. I don't know what it's called in English. But in my language, it's ebewaye. So most of you people know the fish, so I already wash it already. I'm going to put it inside. This is it. Turn together. So like this now, the stew is okay. I will leave it 5 to 6 minutes for the stew to enter inside the fish that I just put now. Then my stew is okay like that. Okay, let's check our stew. Wow. Wow, this is good. This is good. Okay. Our stew is ready, so I'm going to have the gas.